I know.
I do want it.
Yeah. Oh, good. We want it. Every time I hear.
Guys, I am in the captain's office today and he has given me the permission to shoot a little bit, and I can show you what all is over here. We have the extension alarm panel, then we have the egg disc with which he can see from the bridge what all is happening here. Then he has his work computer over here and the desk and, you know, the basic stuff. Okay guys, welcome back to another day, and with me I have my captain Marcin. You guys have seen him so much and you have requested me so much to, you know, ask him a few questions. He's accepted it. And captain, just a brief introduction of you.
My name is Marcin, as you know already, Marcin Slawecki. I'm living in the northwest part of Poland, close to German border, in place called Stargard. Very nice city next to the big lake.
Yes.
Yeah, apparently today we have a very busy day. But a high no, a high no. Eventually, okay. So we have agreed to make this interview because of the heavy weather impacted Europe. We have a lot of delays, so it's a lot of communication going here and there. It's a normal Sunday day, yeah, for the captain.
And thank you very much, captain, to take out this busy day. And guys, he's given me specially after all this changes in ETN. Captain, now a few questions I have decided. So that many of our viewers want to see. So how many years have you sailed in Maersk right now, or before that?
I think in total, if I can recall, there is about 20 years now.
Okay.
Yeah, I would say so. And the last 17 years, I'm working for Maersk Line. Yeah, I went through all the ranks. I joined here as a second mate. When I sailed, I think, the first vessel as a third mate, that was like my trial. And shortly after, I was promoted to second mate.
Yeah.
And shortly after, I was a chief mate, and then I was sailing as a chief mate for quite a few years.
Okay.
Jumping from ship to ship, from class to class, building up my experiences, which I enjoy a lot, actually, to be a chief mate, to be honest. And for the last almost 7 years now, I'm in command as a captain.
And guys, Captain Marcin, he sailed in so many types of classes of vessel. He keeps telling me about, you know, he's taken over Hamburg Sud ship. He was the first captain.
Yes, that's true.
From Maersk to take the Hamburg Sud ship, and he's also taken Bernhard Schulte when Maersk collaborated with them, and he's got a lot of experience, especially with West African ships, the C-class. Captain, next question people want to know is, how did you decide you wanted to join this profession? Like, was this your passion, or was it some goal of yours?
Yes, that is actually a good question. I was thinking about, you know, what actually pushed me, you know, to to join to sea. And actually, I would say, you know, I came from country when we were actually, you know, there was this communist bloc.
Yeah.
So all for the young people, the dream was just to see the world. And I would say by applying to Maritime Academy, there was the good chance at some point, you know, to see what is on the other side of the wall.
Absolutely.
That's why I have decided. And I think that also my mother, she also a bit pushed me, you know.
Just like my father.
Yeah, yeah. And to be honest, I'm the first one in my family who actually went to work at sea.
And Captain, it's not an easy profession, right?
Yeah, that's, yeah, it's not the easy profession, actually. Yeah, it's very dynamic.
It's very dynamic.
Yeah, you have a lots of impacts, lots of messages, and, you know, lots of changes.
Lots of responsibilities.
Day to day, as we have mentioned today, it's a lovely Sunday. It's a lovely weather outside.
And
but,
it's,
you know,
busy.
And it's busy.
And
yeah,
it's busy. All right. So, next question, Captain. What is the biggest challenge you faced in all these years at sea? Like, any rough weather you encountered, which you have a, you know, memory which will last?
Yes, as we discussed many times, actually, when I was promoted to captain, and shortly after, one of my first contracts, it was quite actually difficult. We have actually encountered quite heavy weather, heading to a typhoon.
Okay.
And then there are lots of, you know, people looking at you. You are the one now who has to make these decisions.
Yeah.
Not like in the old days, you look at the captain, you are the captain now.
Yes.
And then you have to, you know, you have this kind of worries, you know, the mindset, and, you know, you have to watch the guys, you have to watch the cargo, because it's the lots of
Yeah.
What is this? A big asset actually given into your hands.
Yeah. And the captain, he's got a big responsibility to decide if you want to navigate further with the same course and speed. And that's a tremendous responsibility for you, right?
Yeah, right. It's not that easy, actually, no, because everybody knows that you are the one, yeah? You are the one, and you don't want to make a fault.
Exactly.
And as I'm always saying, yeah, we have 20 few crew members on board, and this is the most important, the biggest asset which you have here, and, you want to make sure that everybody will go home safe.
That's correct.
That's the kind of responsibility.
Okay, so that was one big challenge you faced when you took the rank.
So. Okay. Otherwise, you know me.
Otherwise, you also know him. What was the best moment at sea, if you can recall anything right now? Like, what you think is your biggest accomplishment?
Yeah, the biggest accomplishment is, just to, as we call this, mission accomplished, So we reach home.
Yes.
We reach actually our destination in one piece, as we call at sea, without having any troubles. The people are safe. The vessel is in good shape, and I think this is the biggest accomplishment, because working at sea, there's a lot of stories which, from day to day, and I don't recall at the moment, something which I have really achieved, which was so super special.
Home safe, that's our motto.
That's our
and
motto,
that's
what
you follow, and that's what you feel the accomplishment when you finish your contract.
And it's also always good to be remembered as a good man at sea.
Absolutely. I'm sure, guys, whatever happens, I'm sure he's about to sign off in a few days, but for the everlasting memories on YouTube, you will see him, and maybe I hope to sail with him again, and we will make a video again. But for now, a very, very big thank you to you, Captain Marcin, for supporting us all. The next question is a bit personal. Like, how do you manage your family while being away for so long? Like, is there any big challenge you face? Sometimes you think of it.
As you know, nowadays actually it's a bit easier for us because we have that
internet,
so we can use WhatsApp and many other actually these social media messengers, etc. So we are pretty much connected with the house, with the wives, our families. But sometimes it is difficult that the wife, she's calling you and would be nice to be there and just support her, and you are far away, and
that's
nothing you can do. Yeah,
that's
nothing you can do. I remember the old days, that was completely different. There was no communication. So once you left home, from time to time, there was, maybe you got this one email or letter, and that's all. So basically, there was one blind spot, and then till you reach the next port, then maybe you can make a phone call,
These days, I was not here, but he was here, as he explained. Once you go at sea, there's no more communication, maybe just telegrams or something from port to port.
Old days,
old days were tough, now it's better, but still, with new things comes new challenges, and that's one of the things that you have addressed also.
Nowadays, we are up to date, I would say, every day we can make a phone call, we can, chat with our families, so we are also, supporting them quite.
Do you still have the same passion and love for sailing as you did when you first joined? I mean, it's a tricky question. Do you still feel the same passionate...
I would say, as long as I feel that, I'm happy to rejoin the new vessel, or the same vessel, depends, if you are back-to-back, that things, yes, are still indeed. Of course, there is a completely different approach. When I was a young, unexperienced, there was more uncertainties.
Yeah.
Now, as a older dog, I know a bit more than young guys, so, I'm more prepared for new challenges. But yes, indeed, I'm still enjoying a lot, and I think I will, if I'll be healthy and fit enough, I will stay for another couple of years at least.
That's really good to know, Captain. So, on that point, Captain, do you want to leave this profession and do something else? You have any plans for doing that?
If I do, I have some plans, of course, but if I do, for sure the things will be related to shipping.
He was telling me that he was trying to apply for pilots, as you must have seen in our videos, the pilot operation. So maybe you are looking forward to that, being a pilot in Poland or something.
That's on my agenda, but let's see how it will work.
Absolutely, Captain. Okay, so if it was not a Merchant Navy, Captain, what else do you think would you be doing?
Actually, before I applied to Maritime Academy, I was looking for this to become a firefighter.
Firefighter, okay.
That's always something new. challenging in my mind.
Okay.
But the decision was 50-50, and I have decided, and
What is the hardest part of you being at on a ship as a captain? What is the most challenging part related to crew or something? What do you think is?
You know, to be a captain, it's a multitasking job. Yeah? Yeah. So you have to, at some point, possess some skills to have this multitasking like a talent. Because, as you know, we have a lot of conversation or a lot of papers of burden and procedures in regards to arrivals, departures, the local regulations.
Yeah.
We have to talk to the office. At same time, we have to support our crews. Many of the guys, they will approach you, you know, some personal
issues
which you have to also somehow
address them
and, you know, just do your best. So as I have called myself already a few times, yeah, there's a lots of complex, you know, multitasking tasks.
Tasks. And that is the hardest part as a captain, what you feel is, you know, challenging most of the time, right?
Yes, yes. And, you know, nowadays, actually, you know, the problem is, like, compared to the old days, that we are, as we call this, multi-culti, yeah?
So multi-crew,
multi-crew, and we have so many nationalities, and
absolutely.
And we are different. All of us, we are different. And sometimes to make, to suffice all, you know, it's not an easy job, but, you know, we're doing our best and we are learning from each other.
That's true. Know? Every day is a good learning for
all
of us.
Exactly.
All right. So, Kevin, before we close this and not take your time, any kind of messages for the young aspirants trying to join this? You know, some good message you have, like what they should keep in mind, anything?
Yeah, this is still a fantastic job. It's a lot of challenges. If you like challenges, that's the place for you.
Yes.
And yeah, you would be able to see, you know, the whole world will be open for you. You will meet a lot of lovely people.
Yes.
From every corner from around the world, you know, as you can see, like here on board, we have Indians. Oh, okay, we won't say it's not this one because they will come here. Indians, the last part of the program will be you could see the magic.
The magic.
What you can see through the magic window, you know, from the captain's cabin. Eh?
Oh, that's the thing.
View, eh?
That's the perfect view, guys. Perfect view. And we are in Bay of Biscay and we'll be heading for London soon and then the European coastal. So stay tuned for all the rest of the updates. And thank you, Captain Marcin, once again.
You're welcome.
Thank you, guys.
No problem.
If you did like this video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and give it a thumbs up. All right, guys. See you later.